Trackwrestling.com here in Paris, World Championships, here with Nazar Kulchytskyy. And Nazar, you are here. Jordan Burroughs asked to be his training partner. Where did that relationship begin with Burroughs?
Jordan invited me to train with him a couple times in Nebraska, and I got there, you know, and we get in a really good relationship. He liked what kind of feel I give him, more like international style, you know, like how Russians, Azerbaijanis, and Georgians wrestle, pretty much can give a similar feel. So he prepared the best for World Championship. So I feel like he liked that, and I always happy to help the champ, you know, to make his legacy, to win a fifth world title. So I'm pretty excited to be here, help him out, and yeah.
You wrestled with Mike Durone. He gave you the nickname Twisted Steel. So, I mean, you're pretty strong yourself, but put into words the feel that Jordan Burroughs gives. I've always said if I could feel Jordan Burroughs' double leg without knowing I could, you know, without getting hurt, basically, I'd love to feel it. What's it like to feel that kind of power?
Oh, man, he's so quick. So quick, so strong. And hope you don't realize, but, like, when you wrestle, you know, in 4 minutes in the match, and he just keep going and going and going at you, you know, and just trying to, his will, just incredible. So really tough guy to wrestle at. And I mean, tough, but at the same time, for me, I try to look a positive way. Every time I get my butt beat by him, you know, next day, I just trying to do better and better. So it's good for me, but trying to give him the best feel I can. But, oh man, that guy is just tough. Sometimes, some mornings, I just wake up and my face hurting. I try to, you know, trying to down block it and stuff, and it's just sometimes go to my face and didn't get double, but sometimes they get me out of position and just keep getting into those.
So you're gonna have that LDR headgear on, right?
Exactly, yep.
What have you learned from Jordan? What have you learned from him in getting to know him?
You know, I start figuring out what it takes to be there, you know, what it takes to be a world champion, what it takes to be in the team, and just he's just such a professional. You know, most what I learned from Jordan is it doesn't matter how many titles he wins, he's always willing to learn, you know, always willing to listen and just to be a student of the sport. You know, and not a lot of people probably know that. I mean, I'm with him, and sometimes, like, I can just feel like maybe I can help him in one position, and he listens all the time and trying to just willing to learn, you know, and I think it's huge. And just very respectful man who willing to learn and just get better every time, doesn't matter how many World Olympic titles he won before. So that's what I learned.
Have you seen a change in him since Rio at all?
Just keep improving, keep improving, keep getting better, you know. I bet he learned a good deal from that experience, but he just want to make legacy, just keep getting better. And yeah, absolutely, he's just getting better every day, and he's only a new man right now. He's hungry. He's hungry that he probably been before that. So
one thing that's interesting to me, Nazar, is you know, when I watch people practice, whether it's Greco or on the freestyle side of things, a lot of times you'll see, you know, rivals, you know, with each other. James Green, the guy that you lost to at the U.S. Open, he's got this spot, but you and him want the same thing. But obviously, him and Jordan, that Nebraska connection, they're very close. You're Jordan's, you know, partner at these championships. What's that dynamic like with you and James Green?
I mean, you know, wrestling is wrestling. If you're wrestling in the mat, you wrestle in the mat. You know, it's you figure out and do your business out there, and outside the mat, it's not that business anymore, you know. So, I mean, we're cool with each other. We hang out, playing some FIFA, playing some Madden. You know, he have a PlayStation. I'm trying to help him too if he asks, you know. It's I just want a USA to do great, but as soon as season starts and as soon as we step in the mat, there's a time to come back to business, you know. But right now, it's you know, it's all cool.
You're a great story, Nazar. Talking with Nazar Kulchytskyy here on TrackWrestling.com. I mean, you were born in Ukraine, come over to the United States. Here you are at the World Championships, Paris, France, part of this USA contingency. Did you ever dream in a million years that you'd be in this position? That wrestling would take you this far in your life all over the world?
You know, I had an idea of that, but I never knew that I'd gonna be living in the United States and helping Olympic world champion, you know.
And you want to make one of these teams yourself.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So I learned a great deal from there as well, you know. I'm around here now and it makes me more hungry. I want to be here next year. And I learned a great deal and, you know, and overall just make American. I want to help them out, whatever it takes to be world champions as a team. I can believe that USA can do it. The next step is World Cup. I believe USA can finally beat Iran, you know. And
that'll be in Iowa City.
Absolutely. And I'm very excited about that. And you know, and just being here makes me hungry to get better myself and represent the United States, the greatest country in the world next
and
year.
And you're a USA citizen, correct, Nazar?
Absolutely.
And you got that fairly recently, right?
In 2014. September 2014.
Okay, so about 3 years ago.
So first term I could wrestle for USA, it was the World Team Trials in 2015.
So, what was that day like, becoming a U.S. citizen for you?
Oh man, that was a blast. I was dreaming about that moment, because when I came to U.S., you know, I had to wait 5 years and all that process, and a lot of paperwork and all that, but, you know, it felt amazing. It felt great. I'm really happy to be a part of this country.
So what's it going to take for you, Nazar, to make one of these teams?
It's gonna take a lot, but a lot of little details need to work on. I have a plan for next season, and as soon as I'm come back from World Championship to Wisconsin, start working that plan, do step by step. Every little step matters, but I have a plan. Takes a lot of hard work, education, and but I believe myself.
And you're training at the Badger Wrestling Club, correct? Yeah, in Madison?
Yes, sir. Yep, Badger Wrestling Club, Madison. I'm actually, it's a Badger RTC right now. We just changed it up.
Okay.
It used to be a Badger Wrestling Club. Now it's a Badger RTC.
You're taking it to Barry and Rochelle in there?
yep. Barry, Rochelle, and Trevor Brandvold, and Camden Evers.
What kind of impact have they had on you training down in Madison? What's been really helpful for you with those guys?
They're great people, you know. They're always willing to come over and help me out, just watch me wrestle, you know, help me out, pick on some little things, improve, you know, and just great people to be around. I'm very thankful to be around them and help from them.
It's always great to catch up, Nazar. You're one of the great guys in the sport. Have fun in Paris.
Appreciate it.